Did you get counterpicked again? Is your opponent a sadistic no-life trash who can do nothing else but inflict suffering upon you? Fear no more, today we'll talk about what to do when lane matchup is extremely unfavorable. You know you will lose it, but you'd like to lose these kind of games more gracefully. For the purpose of this video, we will assume that you are playing a hero capable of some wave clear. If not, well, shame on you for not utilizing mid lane to full potential. Just keep buying selves and hug the tower. Anyway, let's begin. First things first, let's remember that even the biggest and baddest heroes do not reach peak lane performance until later. Level 1, you can easily play as aggressively as them. Spend this time doing your best to send the first wave under their tower. It will briefly give you the advantage of level 2 and might initiate the process where further waves will bounce between the towers too, further limiting the damage you will take while laning. If you anticipate that even at level 1 you will eat quite a lot of damage, shipping out a self never gets old. And, to reiterate on my previous point, every action you take from level 1 until the laning phase disappears should work to set the creep equilibrium to your favor. Every second the wave is not running either direction is every second your opponent can stack his damage on you. So, if you are successful in controlling the wave in your favor and manage to minimize damage taken, you can get by with less regen as a substitute for faster battle. Another thing we'll need to be conscious of is map timings. These consist of two things, the rune timer and the stack timer. Stacking is fairly valuable regardless of lane status, so aim to stack whatever is closest to your current objective. Small camp at minute 2, so you can pick up rune right away, and big camp at minute 3, so you can pick up rune right away. If the lane creeps are at the moment in an unfavorable position, do not feel pressured to trade your HP for those last hits. Just collect experience and you will make up for the difference in stacked camps anyway. An opponent that is holding the creeps on his high ground is an opponent that is neither stacking nor clearing stacks. Once inevitably the enemy reaches bigger and bigger power spikes with levels, we need to be more conscious if we can approach the wave in the first place. If the wave is static on the enemy high ground, the river, or even your high ground, enemy heroes can still orb walk you or throw spells. Only when the creeps are busy under either tower do we have a little more freedom, as the opponent will either be busy last hitting himself or wouldn't be able to reach you. If the wave is static and the enemy seems dangerous, sometimes it's best not to come to the wave at all, go stack, go take rune, clear a camp or pull the wave further towards your tower. And if you're not in the lane yourself, the enemy might take this chance to push out and go stack or take the rune himself. This is your cue to return to the lane and map up whatever is marching towards the tower. What else we can abuse is the fact that we get a rune every minute or two. This might change in the patch. But for now, this means that if a rune is coming up, you can be a little more liberal with your lane movements, take more risks and play a bit more aggressively, just because you will soon get to refresh yourself with a fresh battle charge. If a rune timer is coming up and you're relatively healthy, use this moment to push out the wave in anticipation of the rune. If you've been successfully collecting experience and stacking, even if you missed on quite a lot of last hits due to careful play, you're about to come back simply due to levels earned and the stacks you've made. Higher level allows for more efficient jungle clearing, and a stacked jungle is always more efficient than a single camp. If the opponent remains a threat, it is absolutely okay to abandon laning completely and go rotate through the camps, checking in for the occasional rune and a tower debush. If the enemy cannot find you in lane, he will most likely shep the wave and go look for additional farm opportunities himself, completely cancelling out the fact that you even had a bad lane in the first place. Now, many heroes do reach a nice little power spike with level 6. Maybe the miserable lane you had before became a kill lane in your favor. Maybe the side lane started looking like a juicy snack. Or maybe you will skip the ultimate in favor of extra damage for the jungle stacks. Your decision should always be made according to the current game state. If you have good kill opportunities in mid or sides on any core, go for it. If the enemy himself is making plays in the sides and you don't feel confident just yet, take this opportunity to deliver some tower damage. Your actions should force enemy rotations, which in turn is always equal to space. Only if your sides are drawing even or sitting ahead, and the enemy mid is more interested in the jungle than the game, only then you can afford to catch up from the poor lane in the jungle. But what will most likely happen is the free farmed opposing mid will force the plays from your team instead, and you'll have no other choice but to be a reactionary hero instead of the one that creates action. There are some important guidelines here too. If you're behind and the enemy is ahead, and this applies to the entire team, choose your items that allow you to be active sooner rather than later. For carries, a good example would be Defusal instead of Battle Fury. For mids, cheap stats such as Witchblade or Yule's 10 BKB will also allow you to be active sooner than building tribals into raw damage. And, as always, the best play at any stage of the game with any hero you can do is push, push, push and push. Where from you wanna push will differ from game to game, but the idea stays the same. You shove a wave, someone comes to defend, enemy team splits, kill opportunities arise. Lastly, a 1 mid will always have a higher chance of snowballing with a team than last mid. Except that most last mids will statistically lead to last games, focus on how to best salvage a bad lane, and on some odd matches here and there, you will be able to single-handedly hold the game long enough for your team to establish the lead. This concludes today's topic. Thank you for watching, good luck. Oh, and spoiler alert, we lost the game. Bye-bye.
Mega kill. They're unstoppable. I am that was unreal. Hello, this is Gabe Newell. Thanks for playing Dota 2. Double kill.
Dire's top tower has been denied.
Killing spree.